Hello everyone and welcome back to Easy Dentistry. Our motto to start this channel is to make easy lectures for the students worldwide. All the lectures on Easy Dentistry are for free and there are no paid services. Just you have to do one thing, that is subscribe to our channel and hit on the bell icon so that whenever we upload a new lecture, you get a notification of it. Also do comment and let us know your feedback. Today's topic is very, very important and highly demanded topic by all our viewers, that is oral submucous fibrosis. Oral submucous fibrosis or OSMF was first described in 1952 by Schwartz when he discovered five Indian women in Kenya who were suffering from this specific disease, and he named it as Atrophia idiopathica mucosae oris. Further, in 1953, Joshi in Mumbai, India, described this condition as oral submucous fibrosis, and it was a chronic progressive scarring disease occurring in a population from the Southeast Asian origin. Now, WHO has defined oral submucous fibrosis as an oral precancerous condition, and it is a generalized pathological state of the oral mucosa associated with a significantly increased risk of cancer. Now, the etiology of OSMF, it is due to clonal selection of fibroblast. It is due to stimulation of the fibroblast by the areca alkaloids. The areca nut contains certain alkaloids which cause stimulation of the fibroblast. Then there are certain fibrogenic cytokines which stimulate the fibroblast, and reduction in the collagenase enzyme, deficiency in the collagen phagocytosis, stable collagen structure. This stable collagen structure is due to the release of enzyme catechins and tannins which are present in the areca nut. This produces the collagen with a more stable structure, and the enzyme lysyl oxidase. These are the causative factors for oral submucous fibrosis. Now, the clinical features. It occurs mostly in the second to fifth decade of life. OSMF can be classified as the early OSMF and advanced OSMF. Now, talking about the early OSMF, the clinical features include burning sensation on intake of hot and spicy food, blisters on the palate, ulceration of the oral mucosa, excessive salivation, altered taste, and dryness in the mouth. Further, there may be periods of exacerbation, that is when there is exacerbation, vesicles develop on the cheek and palate. The interval between the two exacerbation periods is between 3 months to 1 year. Now you can see vesicles present on the buccal mucosa. Now petechiae is reported in 22% cases. Petechiae is nothing but the focal vascular dilatation in the oral mucosa, which occurs due to hypersensitivity to the irritants. Now here you can see petechiae found in the tongue of the patient. Now the histopathology of early OSMF, the epithelium may be hyperplastic and juxtaepithelial dilated blood-filled capillaries are seen. Numerous fibroblasts are seen and there is increase in the lymphocyte count. This lymphocyte infiltration is due to tissue reaction of the OSMF. So this is the histopathological picture of early OSMF with hyperplastic epithelium and juxtaepithelial multiple blood vessels can be seen just below the epithelium. Now, advanced OSMF. In advanced OSMF, the oral mucosa is blanched. It is opaque with white fibrous bands. There is symmetrical involvement, and the buccal and the labial mucosa is involved first, and vertical bands are palpable on the buccal and the labial mucosa. So here you can see blanching and opaque appearance of the buccal mucosa, the soft palate and the hard palate, and the restricted mouth opening up to 2 fingers or even less. Then the soft palate shows slight whitish area to dense fibrosis, and there is fixation and deviation of the uvula. This is also called as the characteristic shrunken or the hockey stick uvula of OSMF. So here you can see on the palate there is dense fibrosis and the uvula is deviated, shrunken, and appears as a hockey stick. Now the fossil pillars, in the fossil pillars there is slight to dense fibrosis extending into the pillars causing strangulation of the tonsils. There is dense fibrosis in the pterygomandibular raphe area resulting in the reduced mouth opening. There is circular bands palpable around the mouth orifice. There are circular bands and there is restricted tongue movement. There is atrophy of the tongue papilla and difficulty in swallowing. Now the histopathology, there is atrophy of the epithelium. The palate shows orthokeratosis while the buccal mucosa shows parakeratosis. Increase in the mitotic activity of the cells can be seen. So here this is the histopathological picture of advanced OSMF with multiple collagenous tissue in the connective tissue. Now the subepithelial changes, there are 4 definable stages of OSMF: very early, early, moderately advanced and advanced. This classification is based upon the amount and nature of subepithelial collagen, the edema, physical state of the mucosal collagen, fibroblastic response, mast cells, lymphocytes, plasma cells and collagen deposition. Now the management of OSMF, first the stoppage of habit of areca nut should be done, then the nutritional support should be provided. Increase in the proteins, increase in calories, increase in vitamin B and increased mineral intake is advised. Then immunomodulation can be done with the help of local and systemic glucocorticoids and placental extracts. These immunomodulators, it reduces the inflammation and thus it decreases the fibroblast proliferation and collagen deposition and there is no fibrosis. Further, physiotherapy like mouth opening exercises and heat therapy is advised. Then local drug delivery of injectable corticosteroids, placental extracts, hyaluronidase and collagenase is advised. Then the combination of all these therapies and finally surgical management of OSMF is advised. Now certain biologic studies. First, the blood chemistry and hematology, deficiency of vitamin B12, folate and iron, it affects the integrity of oral mucosa. Blood findings in OSMF includes increase in the ESR, anemia, eosinophilia, increased gamma globulinemia,